In the last video, I talked about millets that are cultivated in India, their common names and their role in prospering the great flora. In this video, I'm going to talk about sorghum or jowar in detail, its nutritional composition as well as benefits on the health. Let's have a look at the nutritional composition of jowar per 100 grams as per ICMR or Indian Council of Medical Research. 100 grams of jowar gives you 349 calories, around 72.6 grams of carbs. Jowar is a very good source of dietary fiber, which accounts for 39% of IDA. Jowar also provides 10.4 grams of protein, which fulfills 17% of the IDA. Jowar is also rich in iron, which fulfills 24% of the IDA. Very good source of vitamin B1 or thiamine, which completes 31% of IDA. Also a good source of niacin, which completes 19% of IDA. An extremely good source of magnesium, which completes 50% of IDA. A good source of copper as well, which completes 46% of the IDA. A decent source of zinc, which completes 13% of IDA. Jowar is also rich in branched-chain amino acids. Now, which are the branched-chain amino acids? Those are valine, isoleucine and leucine. In jowar, leucine accounts for 880 mg per gram nitrogen of the BCAA. Leucine is vital for musculoskeletal protein synthesis. Jowar also contains phytate, which is 172 mg. It is very low in saturated fats. It is also a good source of vitamin K1, which completes 79% of IDA, which is pretty impressive. Glycemic index is the value that is assigned to foods based on how slowly or how quickly these foods can cause increase in the blood glucose levels. Simple carbs are rapidly digestible carbs. They are devoid of fiber, hence they have high glycemic index. Complex carbs, on the other hand, are made of polysaccharide chains, hence they are slow digesting starch. They are high in dietary fiber, hence they have low glycemic index. Healthy pancreas uptake glucose through insulin by insulin receptor which are present on the cell walls. In type 1 diabetes, the beta cells of the pancreatic islets don't secrete insulin, hence insulin needs to be taken from outside to regulate blood glucose levels. Hence, there is deficiency of insulin in type 1 diabetes. In type 2 diabetes, there are hyperinsulinemia conditions. What does that mean? It means that there is excess of insulin in the body. It also means that there is a certain dysfunction with insulin. This condition is called as insulin resistance, that is, the cells fail to respond to insulin properly. Magnesium is one such potent mineral which has been found to increase insulin sensitivity. According to ADA or American Diabetes Association, a study conducted on type 2 diabetes patients concluded that fiber reduces insulin spikes. So in this study, a 55% carbohydrate diet with or without fiber was given. In the first case, where the fiber was not given, plasma insulin levels did not fall over time. Whereas the same diet with same percentage of carbs when was included with fiber responded by decrease in plasma insulin levels. Now, according to the latest research, insulin is the major cause of weight gain. Hence, consuming high fiber diet will reduce the amount of insulin produced, thus preventing obesity-like conditions, which are dangerous to health. In the next video, I'll take bajra or pearl millet and how it benefits our health. If you like my video on jowar, please hit like button and subscribe my channel NutriVit. Also comment on the video if you found anything good or bad and let me know about it. Thank you.